very strangely ironical, but some 15 years back when I decided to take a road less traveled, since then I've been doing only one thing: travel. Right, you know? And this is my event number 136th in the last since January 2012, across some 4 or 5 countries in almost every state of India. And I'm so privileged and so delighted to be in the middle of you all. Thank you very much for inviting me over. Right, you know? Okay, we begin with a small exercise, and I think we must exercise early in the morning, you know? Right, you know? All of you have been given A4 sheets. Just take 3 seconds to take them out and put them in front of you in a landscape way. Not as a portrait way, but as a landscape way. Just be with me 100% and put them in a landscape way. Your 3 seconds are over now. Take out your pens or pencils now. Keep the sheet on some surface so that you can work on it. 5 more seconds for you. Take out your pens or pencils. Okay, time over. Now, all set? Oh, great. All you do is, I'm giving you 30 seconds, that's 30 seconds, because we don't, time is a premium here. 30 seconds, and you have to immediately, ASAP, upfront, draw a scenery. Quickly draw a scenery. Quick, all of you in here. And allow me to be privy to what you're drawing by jumping down and seeing what the hell you're doing. Quickly draw a scenery, 30 seconds. 5 seconds over. Quick. Very good. Quick. Very nice. Quick. Wow, you need to be very quick. Very nice. Let me see the people at the back, what they're doing. Last with 10 seconds left, quickly. Very nice. Quick. Okay. We'll just stop in here. Guys, you can do it for the next 5 more seconds. Quickly draw your scenery. 5 more seconds by the time I get back on stage. Okay, great. Excellent. Okay, time up. Wow, fantastic. Let me tell you something very cutely beautiful which I observed. You know? And something cutely beautiful which I observed was that 90% of the sceneries look alike. In majority of the sceneries, there's a mountain. There's a sun rising, and therefore, teen char kabutar are flying. There's a house, there's a man, there's a river, something like that, right? Yeah? Right? Am I right? Okay. Now, okay. This is, I'm sure, very much validating the fact that conformity is so much, you know, deeply rooted into our psyches. You know, it is programmed our genes to a level that it has become a biological imperative with us right now. You know, it all started because I think it traces us back to a time when man used to live in caves, thousands of years back. He used to live alone, and to survive, he had to be together. Right? When he moved out of the caves, he made tribes. Tribes had a very strong, subtle influence or psychotic influence on him. From tribes, he moved to villages, from villages to towns, and towns to Bangalores. Right? And man thought that the problem of living alone had gotten solved, but rather it had got aggravated. If you look into the people who live in Bangalore, who go to Infosys together in buses like herds, right, you know, lagta hai ki sabhi ikatthe hain, lekin yaar, ek mehfil mein hajaron mehfilein sharik hoti hain, kisi ko bhi nazdeek se dekhiye, akela hi milega, right, you know? So, that didn't solve the problem of conforming or living in a herd, rather it aggravated, because living alone, there was a deep, deep desire to merge with something larger, to generate some illusory feeling of security, you know. So we started living in a herd way. Let me get out of the, I'm not here for some sociological inferences we can do sometime later. Let me talk about my own self, you know, right. By education, I'll leave the scenery here, beautiful scenery. Please collect your scenery, it's a heritage item, right, you know. Okay. By education, I'm a fashion guy. I started fashion from India's number one, rather, when I started, it was Asia's number one fashion school, NIFT, New Delhi. Right, I really didn't know what I was doing when I joined, you know, because the only reason why I joined was because I had gotten through the entrance exam. Right, and in India, I think, is the only country wherein people become engineers and MBAs first and then decide or think what they want to do in their lives. Right, so I got through the exam, and what I did there was, trust me, very embarrassing. People have aptitude, attitude, and personality. I had one more thing, which was majburi. You know, because parents had told people back home, my parents were reputed doctors in the hometown, right? You know, they told everyone, you know, our son has got through NIFT, you know, and they were thinking, "Hamare bete ki zindagi FTV ki tarah hogi, hogi," right? You know, so, but nothing like that happened. You know, I managed to barely pass. I was amongst the poorest of the students out there. But when it came to placements, I got a good placement because, you know, placements happen because if you can speak good English, you can get a good placement, right? So, I got a good placement and started working in the fashion industry. The first job, the people were really intelligent. They took 6 months to sack me. within 6 months, I received a letter that, okay, they didn't interfere with my confidence because I thought NIFT ka label acha hai, thappa acha hai. A reference got me into a second job. And the people in the second job were smarter than the first job people, you know, because the previous ones took 6 months, they took 3 months, you know. And this time, the reasons they gave were very interestingly funny, and they said one of the reasons was demotivating colleagues at workplace. And I was shattered, you know. I really didn't know what was happening, what the hell was happening with my career. My career graph was like that of Abhishek Bachchan, you know. A good heritage, but no work, right, you know. So, didn't know what the hell was happening, you know. Living in Delhi, I used to live in South Delhi, you know, it's difficult to live in South Delhi, especially when you have a girlfriend. You have so many bills to pay. And it can get difficult to sustain, maintain, and even retain a girlfriend in South Delhi. I didn't tell back home that I've been sacked from the second job because dad was very strict. He would have taken the skin out of me. So there was a need to do something, and I didn't know what to do. I used to go for the interviews, the garment industry merchandiser interviews, production manager interviews, fashion interviews. But every time I used to sit in front of the interview room, I used to feel nauseated. You know, that ganda feeling, no, that I don't belong to this place, yeah. It doesn't resonate with me. This is not what I want to do in my life. Even if I join this job, I'm not going to be here after some time. So there was a notoriety nauseation which was happening within me, you know. It was not inspired living, it gave me a feeling, you know. I was feeling like a hollow man. You know, a corpse within me was trying to get interviewed, you know, and trying to get a job. I was actually on the road. I didn't know what was happening with me. Right. My girlfriend gave me a fantastic idea. It was brilliant. She said, if you think we have to go along, you have to do another MBA, especially if possible from an IIM. Right. And it was intelligent, right, you know, to clear the cutoff of his father's credentials, you know, so I had to. She in fact paid for my fees at a coaching class in Delhi, so I enrolled in that class. I studied for CAT, and interestingly, I cleared the CAT paper. I was good at English and a few other things, average okay at them. So I cleared the paper and got good calls. One of the top IIMs where I wanted to get through, since I already had done my post graduation, so I was very eclectic about where to join. One of the top IIMs I got a call from there. I prepared well. I thought I'll get through. I had a good interview, but they rejected me in the interview. Right, that was very hurting. You know, I thought I had a good interview. Taking a detour from my story, life is very comical at times. The same IIM some 3 months back, they invited me to their campus, paid me to train their second year students for their placements. Right, you know. So, anyways, it happens only in India, right, you know. Okay, so let me come back to my story, right, you know. So, I had to do something to, you know, make money. So, one thing which I was good at in my growing up years was I was good at singing. I thought I was okay at singing, not very good at singing, you know. And I had a great propensity or liking for pop numbers, rock numbers. So on weekends, I joined a reputed pub, a resto bar in Connaught Place in Delhi. They used to, for 6 or 7 songs that I used to sing on a weekend, they used to give me 500 rupees, free booze, free food, and a chance to look at the guests out there. Right, you know? So I thought it was good. 500 then was very good, some 15 years back. It was amazing money, you know. So I started doing that. I kept on doing that for 1 year. By the time two incidents happened. One was very interesting, wherein my girlfriend, one fine morning, she walks up to me and says the same dialogue which Shah Rukh Khan used sometime back in a movie. "To kya hua agar hum ikatthe nahi ho sake? Hum ek achhe dost ki tarah to reh sakte hain." Right, you know? So, right, you know? So, she got married to someone who is matrimonially the best qualified in India, IIT plus an IIM, right, you know. And last I checked 3 years back, she's still living in Bangalore. She has 2 dogs, 1 husband and 1 child. Right, you know. Okay, I also took vengeance. I have one wife, one child, and no dogs yet. Right, you know. So, anyways, coming out of the part, I always had the dream, you know, I don't know how it, from where it came, but since my growing up years in my school, there was one thing which was a litany feature of my growing up, and that used to inspire me, excite me, draw me, pull me, propel me, was like a suction point. It was that dream that I want to be in, I want to be speaking in large, huge auditoriums. I want to use powerful mics, address a house full audience, and speak my heart out. It was a dream which used to regularly occur. Sounds filmy, but yeah, it was. Maybe it was some my previous karma or some previous birth. I don't know, I believe in those things, but possibly the deja vu something from that. It used to come regularly to me. So my mother also helped me understand, Akash, you're convincing. You helped my peon quit alcohol. You know, something like that. You know, you helped the children of my kitty party, Sahelis, you know, make their career right, you know, score good marks. So small fragmented incidents added to my confidence that I should get into public speaking, you know. I started doing sundry jobs here and there. Chota mota kaam, you know, taking some classes in a coaching class, or school trainings, teacher trainings, workshops for kids, some third grade corporate jobs training out there, you know. So I started doing this stuff, you know. But it was not hot. It was like I was reading from a book, Ratta Maratha or Jake Bolratha. You can win, right? You know, stuff like that, you know. So, all right, now, so, you know, so, I was faking it out. Basically, I was faking it out. I was desperate to earn money. I was desperate to get attention. Look at me, I'm a corporate trainer, baby. Look at me, right? You know, so, and I was getting that attention in 25%, but I knew it was hopeless a deal because it was not heart centric. Then the biggest tragedy happened on me, on my family. My father left us, he passed away, and that was a void which we're still able to, we're not able to fulfill. And the separation anxiety prodded me to get back to the herd again. You know, you understand, when you're lonely, you want to, you know, merge with the herd again, you know. My mother and my brother, who were living in the hometown, they said, "Wapis aaja, we're setting up a business." My brother had already set up a disco business, a restaurant, a beer bar. Come back, you don't have to do much, join in, have a good life in here. The loneliness, the complexes, and the uncertainty, and the fearfulness, I just went back. Right, I was there for almost more than a year. I ran a discotheque along with my brother. And you know what happened? It was absolutely picture perfect life, you know. A lot of money coming, a palatial house to live in. You come back at the home at 8:30 in the night in C Star Plus. Family, you know, it was like everything was good, but then, you know, I somewhere, that kida was there, invisible kida, that I had buried my dream somewhere deep, you know, that dream used to recur again, you know, the inner child within me was getting killed somewhere, and the rebelliousness was at its peak. It was oozing out of my nerves. I was feeling that I'm cheating myself. I had been bought out by the comfort or the security of a money flow, right? You know, it was not me. It was not an inspired living. And it came, it snowballed to a level that it became obnoxiously nauseating to me. And one night, even after, I shared this with my mother and my brother, but they didn't seem to much understand, right? I had no other idea but to run away. Because agar main unse baat karta to unhone wo Hindustan jaisa hota hai, tere ko kya karna hai, sab kuch to hai, right? You know, I knew they would not understand, and it was not me that I was doing. So I ran away, and I'm sorry to them publicly. I'm apologizing before them that I didn't talk to them and I ran away, right? For 9 months they didn't even speak with me, right? I came to a city called Chandigarh, then I started from scratch again. When I came to Chandigarh, I was on a zero. I didn't have anything. But there's one thing which I had, my best chance, you know, to give my 100%, because I had nothing to lose, everything to gain. You know, it was my best chance to give in everything that I had to commit to the dream which I've always been wanting to allege myself to. Main Chandigarh mein aane ke baad, pehle jo main karta tha, waisa kuch nahi kiya. Maine ek nayi cheez ki. I, in my talks, in my events, I gave what was true me, honest me, right? I was fearless. खूब सारा मेहनत किया यार, अगर 10 काम करने थे तो मैंने 15 किए, जहां 200 रुपया लगना था वहां 500 लगाया, राइट? अगर एक्स यूनिट्स ऑफ कुछ करना था तो मैंने एक्स प्लस वाई किया. आई एग्जॉस्टेड माइसेल्फ. आई गेव माय 100% टू एनीथिंग दैट वाज कमिंग माय वे, एंड इट वाज जेन्युइन. Right. I created events. Which were me, you know, fearless blogs, fearless events. And for example, I found in the corporates that people in the corporate were stressed, depressed, but still well dressed. There was a need to break their erroneous beliefs. You know, my events were my zealot efforts to entertain them, to use sarcasm as a medium to actually make some better dents. You know, I did it 100%. You know, and you wouldn't believe while I was doing all that, no one asked me questions. I went and talked to the CEOs of Fortune 500 companies in my talks. No one asked me how much you educated. They didn't ask me. I didn't tell them. Right. It proves in affirmation in the mind that qualifications do not matter. I think confidence only does. Right. You know. So. And while I was doing this heart-centric life, it was like the best part of my life. I didn't try to do many things. I just did fewer things. But the fewer things that I did them really well. I gave my 200% on them. So I learned, boss, if you need to be laser focused, you need to be sharp focused into your own path. Once you're laser focused, I think success is incidental. The world was waiting for me. I didn't even realize that the world was so much waiting for me. It rewarded me, right? My rates, which I used to charge some 10 years back, I raised them some 150 times. And the world was still inviting me. So the learning I had was if you are convinced about something, convincing others would be incidental, right? Anyways, let me come back to my story. If you're on the road less traveled, you are always romantically challenged. You know? So, I was trying to get married and I found it difficult. Right? You know, in marriage, Hindustan, mama is always involved. You know, so he tried to convince my prospective mother-in-law. You know, ki boss, mother-in-law ne pucha Punjabi mother-in-law ki ladka karta kya hai? Mama ne kaha bolta hai. Mama unne kaha ki ladke to hamare mohalle ke bhi bolte. So mama ne kaha nahi usko bolne ke paise milte. Mother-in-law kaha after 1 minute she said kya guarantee hai ki paise milte rahenge, right? You know, so it was like, you know, very difficult in when you're on your own road. It's very difficult to convince people, boss, ki ab kya kar rahe ho, kyun kar rahe ho, kaise kar rahe ho. In fact, my recommendation would be don't even try to convince them. Keep on making silent progress. Don't make noise. You know, the amplification will happen on its own. Don't try to impress people, you know, with your journey progress. Look at this, friends, my new iPhone 5 ass, you know, or for that reason, you know, I did this, I did that, I went for a vacation there. Keep on making silent progress and, you know, the people will get answered on their own, you know. Some second thing which really helped me in my journey was fitness, you know, I found that I could not beat my friends in marks, in competitive exams, in health. In career, in job, in car, in relationship. But there's one thing which I wanted to beat them on, it was health. I made fitness a part of my life. Wherever I am, I try to run for at least 45 minutes in every day. Majority of your friends are becoming junk in trying to win this rat race. You can make a statement by taking this road less traveled. Be fit. Spondylitis, back pain, hypertension, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases are happening between 25 and 50. You can make a statement by not running in the rat race, but by in a park by putting on a running shoes, right? You know, you can be fit. If you're fitness, then there's juice to your life. In fact, there's more life to your ears and ears to your life. Everything is falling in place, right? Third thing which is a detour from the road less traveled is I'll recommend you strongly to have excellent relationships in life. You know, commit yourself to the only measure of a person's success is how good he is in relationships with people in his life. You know, make parents your integral part, relevant to your story, relevant to your progress, relevant to your life. Give them significance. Being brothers is genetic, but staying brothers is difficult. It requires character. You know, today you might be a rock star, you might be a millionaire, you might have six packs, but if your Valentine, if your spouse is not your best friend, trust me, everything else is a zilch. Right? Have fantastic relationships on your journey. You'll feel the loneliness will be kept cared of by the people in your life then. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, if you look at the animal kingdom, you know, all the strong ones and the powerful ones, they walk alone. It's only the meeker ones and the weaker ones who move in a herd, you know, who graze together. You know, if you're moving in a herd, the herd behavior, it never allows that rebellious thinking. It never allows that creative instincts to flow through you. It never permits you that 100% value unlocking to happen. The joyfulness, the abundance, they're always elusive. You know, you will never be able to savor the joy of thinking on your own feet. You know, do something which no one else has done. dazzle the world with your brilliance. Ordinary is too boring, yeah? I'm 36 right now, and I've got a dream in front of me. I've got lots on the agenda next. I want to run more. I want to pray more. I want to meditate more. I want to have fantastic relationships with my people back home. And more important than everything else, I want to inspire more. I want to travel more and meet many thousands and lakhs of people like you. I want to meet them and inspire more and share my own mistakes so that they don't make those mistakes or learn them early. Right. And 15 years back, I had this choice to do an MBA from a top B school. Had I done it today, I would have been some near to a CEO of a multinational company. 10 years back, I had a choice to carry on my family business with my brother and remain secure right through my life. I'm so glad I did not exercise any of the two choices. I exercised a choice which was my road, which went through my heart. You know, sorry, dunya ka paisa ek taraf yaar, aur sorry, dunya ki security ek taraf. Par wo jo ek feeling aati hai na, wo kick aati hai. Jab aapke liye hazaron lakhon log wait kar rahe hote auditoriums mein aapko sunne ke liye, aur aap unki life mein kuch problems solve kar rahe hote, you are value adding to them. Wo paisa aur security ek taraf, wo feeling ek taraf. Aur wo feeling jab aati hai, you believe you have validated your road less traveled. And I'm savoring my feeling, and I'm really enjoying it. That's my story of my road less traveled. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I want to do something. Can you play that small? Something I thought would take my back to my Connaught Place days. Some. Make champagne on ice, she said. We are all just prisoners here of our own device. In the master's chambers, we gathered for the feast. Stab it with the steely knives, but the chest can't kill the beast. Last thing I remember, we were running for the door. Had to find my passage back to the place I was before. Relax, said the nightman, we are programmed to receive. You can check out.